अस्मद् गुरुभ्यो नमः, अस्मद् सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः, अस्मद् परमगुरुभ्यो नमः। श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मी नृसिंह परब्रह्मणे नमः। श्रीमदे शिवंशरगोपैश्चिवेदान्तदेशीयदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः। श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मी नृसिंहदिव्यपादुका सेवक शिवंशरगोपैश्चिनारायणदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः। श्रीमदे शिवंशरगोपैश्चिरङ्गनाथदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः। श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कविधार्किककेसरि वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे। वन्दे वृन्दावनचरं वल्लवीजनवल्लभं जयन्ती सम्भवं धाम वैजयन्ती विभूषणम् जन्मात्यस्य यदोन्वयादितरदस्सार्थेष्वभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्महृदायादिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजो वारिमृदां यदा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा दाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तगुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि निगमकल्पधरोर्कलिदं फलं शुगमुघादमुदद्रवसंयुधं पिबदभागवदं रसमालयम् भुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमः। नमः पङ्कजनाभाय, नमः पङ्कजमालिने, नमः पङ्कजनेत्राय, नमस्ते पङ्कजाङ्ग्रये। वेदत्तैवेदत्तिन् शुवैपयनै विळिमिय முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார் களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லாம் மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமையிலை திருவல்லிக்கே நிகண்டேனே வசுதேவ சுதம் தேவம் கம்சசானூரமர்த்தனம் தேவகி பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும் त्वं तु सर्वं परित्यज्य स्नेहं स्वजनबन्धुषु मया वेश्य मनः सम्यक् समदृग्विचरस्वगां यदिदं मनसा वाचा चक्षुर्भ्यां श्रवणादिभिः नश्वरं गृह्यमाणं च विद्धि माया मनोमयम् पुंसो युक्तस्य नानार्थो भ्रमस गुणदोषभाक् कर्मा कर्म विकर्मेदि गुणदोषधियोभिधा तस्मात् युक्तेन्द्रियक्रामो युक्तचित्त इदं जगत् आत्मनीष्यस्वविदधं आत्मानं मय्यधीश्वरे ज्ञानविज्ञानसंयुक्त आत्मभूतशरीरिणाम् आत्मानुभवदुष्टात्मा नान्तरायैर्विगन्यसे दोषबुद्ध्यो भयादीदो निषधान्न निवर्तते गुणबुद्ध्या च विहितं न करोति यदात्मगः सर्वभूतसुहृत्शान्तो ज्ञानविज्ञाननिश्चयः पश्यन्मत् आत्मगं विश्वं न विपद्येत वै पुनः। सो वि आर् कमिङ्ग् टु दि लेक्चर् 90th one. यस्टर्डे वि स्टार्टेड् दि श्लोक दि वन् वित् दि कृष्ण वास् ट्रैङ्ग् टु एक्स्प्लैन्. First I told you 7 slokas Uddhava, and then I was telling about the Yadu Maharaja and the Avadhuta Samvadam, about all the 24 gurus. That is done. That is a very generic one. Now I give you a simple way to implement, specific for anyone. So when you look at the cloud, when you look at the tree, when you look at the water, when you look at the fire, everybody learns. It's a very generic one. So many cars are there, all you have to say is there's a steering wheel, you drive. But it is not the same. Each car is a little different. Four cylinder, or whether it's a station wagon or a minivan. So whether it's got a snow tires, four wheel drive, all those things are different each one. Similarly here, for each of the persons what we are, there is a different kind of a dharma, different kind of karma we should be doing. So that is what he is concentrating over here. So we saw yesterday the sloka started it. Sri Bhagavan Uvacha Maya Udideshu Abhidaha Swadharmeshu Mat Ashrayaha Varnashrama Kula Acharam Akama Atma Samacharet. I try to break all the words so it is easy to understand. Swadharmeshu Varnashrama Kula Acharam. So your Swadharmam, what you should be doing, what is the righteousness for you is determined by the rest of them. Acharam, Kulam, Varnashramam. That will determine what you should be doing. Even though it's a generic car, these are the specific things to you. So we started yesterday saying at the end, Kintu Anushtana Nityatvam Swatantriyam Abhakarishyati. Even a small thing somebody is forcing you to do, that one, that means your freedom is gone. So we do all the time, we say that one. So when the mother says that one, why don't you get up? He says, no, today is Saturday, today is a weekend, why should I get up? Let me sleep, why don't I have some freedom? This is a very common one. But if you really like it, you get up at 6 o'clock and do any everything. So here, the kinds of things what you do, Kintu Anushtanam, the Anushtanam what you do, Nityatvam, Nityakarma Anushtanam what we do, it pleases the Bhagavan. That is the reason why we do that. Because Bhagavan himself said at some point, Shruti Smriti Mamai Vakya. Mamai Vakya, Shruti Smriti. Hey, Vedas and whatever all the sutras what people have written, like Harida Smriti, Manu Smriti, Sandalya Smriti, all those things is my Agyai. I ask you to do, follow those things. You have to be obedient to that one. That's what Bhagavan says. So, Shruti Smriti Mamai Vakya, Yastam Ullangya Vartade, Agya Chedi Mamadrogi, Mat Bhaktobi Na Vaishnavaha. Beautiful words. Bhagavan uses very harsh word here. Mamadrogi, Agya Chedi. If one trespasses that, then he is my Drogi. Mat Bhaktobi, he may call, is my Bhakta. He is not a Vaishnavan. He does not belong to Vishnu. Is Vishnu's all the kinds of people in that clan, it does not belong to that. So you have to follow the Nitya Karmas, that is what he is saying over there. So, Kintu Anushtana Nityatvam, yes, we have to get up at 6 o'clock. We have to spend about 10 minutes doing Sandhya Vandanam. We have to do in the evening also. All these things bothers. And once a year you have to do, if you don't have the parents, all the Shraddham. And the Amavasai and the kind of a thing, you have to do the Tarpanam. It takes away your free time. But unfortunately, that is what it is. In my work, when I used, in my previous, previous generation, whatever I was working on in previous life, at that time I used to be a manager. When I ask all the technical people to do the weekly report, monthly report, what they do, they said, I don't have no time. I tell them, if you don't write it, whatever 100% you do is useless. Because you have to have a stuff, you have to have the fluff. So this is a fluff kind of a thing. Unless you have some overhead, nobody will know what you are doing. Similarly, we are having 100% of the time to the body, you need at least 10% of the time. So one of the elderly gentlemen taught me, Sandhya Vandanam 3 times you have to do. 8 minutes, 8 minutes, 8 minutes. That's all you need, 24 minutes. Bhagavan gave you 24 hours, we give back 24 minutes. That's all you have to do. In ours, they never mandated you got to go to any time to temple. They never mandated to do all the puja, elaborate one. No yagam, no yagyam. There are certain mandated rituals you have to do. Like the Ubanayanam, Vivaham, Pumsavana Simandam, all those things we have to do. Other than that, nothing is mandated. No religion is like that one. You are completely free. And many times you can even do parallel processing. After taking shower, you are wearing the suit and tie and everything. You can tell all the slokas. When you are driving the car, you can tell the slokas. all the different kinds of things we can do, they give you freedom. So Bhagavan here is asking, there are certain things called Nitya Karma. If you don't do Sandhya Vandanam and you do elaborate prayer, it is useless. Very simple way to understand is, if you don't do the regular hours, RT, regular time, there is no OT, there is no overtime. You have to do the regular time, then only you can go for the overtime. Regular time is like a Nitya Karma. Overtime is going for the temple, doing pradakshinam, yagam and everything. You cannot go there until you do this. This is very similar to the guy says, if I eat 10 chapatis, I will be full. Then he says, why don't you start with the 10th chapati? You can't. You have to do the 9th. So similarly here, you have to do the Nitya Karma. Then only you have to do. Even if you don't do any of the other things, it is not necessary. Nothing is expected out of. Bhagavan says these are mandated. That's the reason why we had to be doing that. So coming back here, we saw a little bit on the acharam yesterday. The acharam starts from several things. Mainly because what our elders have followed. Shishtacharam, that's what we call. Why you are doing like this one? Because my parents are taught like that. Their parents taught like that. That is the way we do. The most important is how you keep your body clean, how you keep your vastram clean, how you keep the food what you are eating is clean, and how you keep your mind clean. That's all it is. That's all the acharam basically talks. So whenever you do for Bhagavan, you want to have a very clean clothes. So that is the reason why you put a muddy, what they call acharam, put it up there in the stick and it dries and then you go and wear that one. And in the morning you do with the empty stomach because you are not interrupted by going to the bathroom and everything. So similarly, agharam is very, very important. Very important. Let me give one example. When you cook and everything, one of the problem here, many people, they keep on talking on the phone and cook. So when you talk, sometimes it is a sattva buddhi, sometimes it is a rajo and tamasa gunas. So whatever you are doing, that goes into the food. How come it is? That is what you do. When you do the punya vachanam, when you do all this kind of mantra, udaga shanti, we put the darbai, when you do the mantra, by the resonance it goes, all this vibration goes into the water. Similarly, your vibration when you are talking to the friend, all the bad things and telling about somebody else, all the bad, everything goes into the food. There was one rishi was there, very nice guy. And he ate in somebody's house and he slept. Next morning, something has happened to his head. He stole the silver vessel from that house. So he went halfway and then he realized, I never did like this in my life. Why did I do like that? Then the drishti, jnana drishti come to him and says, that house what you ate, the man made the money in the wrong way. That is why when you eat in that house, you inherit that qualities. That is the reason why paraannam, outside the food, our elders will not eat. Because they will eat only in some specific houses, not random houses. Now we eat in the restaurants and hotels and everything. Do you think that they have done everything with their sattva gunam? Even though it tastes good for your tongue, all the bad things are getting in there. That is how we are getting. So here he says, agara suddhi, agara niyamam is very, very important. Not only the good oil you use, good flour you are using, good kind of wheat and rice you are using. That's not the one. The way how it is cooked.
I think you have mentioned an example of Bhishma Pitamaha. He was at Duryodhana's...
Correct. See, Duryodhana used to give all of them and the food and he tries to make. So we see all the places like that one. We inherit all those kind of qualities. That is why eating the food outside unknown places we had to avoid. Sometimes we cannot do that one, we do. But just for the taste only, we are all human beings. We are not robots. Okay, so even if you just do it for taste, don't do it too often. That's what I am trying to say. So, but you can eat in all the, your satsangam people, they make wonderful food. They say all the time, here Jyoti says, whenever I cook this, keep on saying the Duhe Mantra. And when it comes, the taste is so good. Why? Because Bhagavan blesses that. See, we give the same ingredients. So many shows we saw, see that one. Same ingredients. Same sambar makes. Same kind of chapati and sabji they make. Everything is the same ingredient, same stuff. How come each one is different? So that is what it is. Bhagavan blesses that one. So we have to be very careful what we make with a good mood, good intention, and also where we eat, that is also very important. So that is what when you say achara means, that is what he's emphasizing. So mainly when we know achara means, oh, don't touch him, he doesn't want to touch, oh, you won't eat there. But you have to know why it is behind that. There is a reason behind all of them. That is why Krishna is doing. Similarly, as I said, another one, the cooked food and non-cooked food. Don't mix those two. Because cooked food will become stale. It will go bad after some time. So that's why rice when you cook and a yogurt when you have, don't touch each one of them, they try to do. Because your hands got bacteria. That is how you are fermenting. Don't say there's nothing. That is how all the you make for batter for your idli or dosa or you are making the yogurt. That's how it does. So when you touch this one and go over there, naturally everything is passed over there. That's why they say, wash your hand. Wash your hand. So you try to put it separately when you try to do in the kitchen. And one other thing we used to do in those days, they don't, when you eat the food, after that one, I don't know whether it's practiced in your place, they wash that with the cow dung.
Yeah.
They wash.
In old days, yeah.
In old days. Yeah. They wash with the cow dung at that one for the purification and everything. Anything comes from the cow is very pure.
Right.
Everything, whether it is the urine or the cow dung or the milk, from that milk, whatever you're getting, the yogurt or whether it's a butter, all of them are, the cow is the most sacred one. So, because cow gives the life for everybody, and when we see Krishna, there is nothing else more he likes it other than the cows, the small calf. That's what he really loves. So, when you look at this one, we don't do that one, or at least when you eat, take a tissue paper with the wet water or something, clean that one so that it does not spread to everybody. That is why, that's the whole idea they try to do, is clean that one. And also, the same thing when we sleep, in the bed, lot of things, when you in your body also, so many dead cells are falling off. So that is why after bath, they said don't go back to the bed and sleep. So if at all you have to sleep, you have to have some protective sheet. That's why what you do is you put some plastic sheet or something. That is why old ladies and old grandpas and everything in our place, they will have the pillows not made up of cotton. Outside, they will have something with the oil cloth, that's what they call. The cloth will have an oil kind of a thing, like a plastic kind of a thing. So that will not stick onto that. So many times what they can, even the, we do the dole here, when the Perumal comes, they always try to use with the plastic. Plastic is called Suddha Sattvam, because nothing sticks to that. It never gets wet, that is why. So that is why plastic is used for many of things. On the carpets and everything, they put plastic. And sometimes even Radhika uses a plastic gloves to touch everything and take all of them. Whether it is absolutely correct or not, at least that's part we can do. So what I'm trying to say, understand all of them, this is what it is. But we are taking shortcuts in many places. So shortcut is not a mainstream, but we have to understand what it is. So acharam, anushtanam. Acharam is the rule, anushtanam is what you follow. To do that, you need vairagyam. So whenever you see acharam, anushtanam, vairagyam, all of them will be coming together. Whenever you want to follow the rules, you have to have a determination. So that is the vairagyam that tells. So jnanam alone will not take you anywhere. Jnanam along with anushtanam, this acharam and this vairagyam, that will get you the bhakti. So I know Krishna is a great Lord. So Krishna is a Paramatma. So you cannot lie down on the bed at night 12 o'clock and say, I am doing my puja here. You can think of Krishna. But for the puja, there is a particular way you have to do. There is an anushtanam is mandated. So you cannot do anything. Let me put my feet up there. Let me put my shoes and everything. Even though I am dirty, I'll do. There are some places dirty things are allowed because that person cannot take bath. He's old. He's senile. That is allowed. But not everything. So don't take the exception as the mainstream. So here it says, acharam and anushtanam and vairagyam. Bhakti has got two legs. One leg is jnanam, the other leg is anushtanam. We need those two. In one of the, even in Vedas, they say that one, you have a jnanam without anushtanam is like the dog's tail. What the dog's tail? It is not covering what it is supposed to cover or anything. It is not useful anything at all, but it is wagging. For what? Similar to that one. So your jnanam is completely useless unless you put it correctly into practice. That is why anushtanam is very important. Some anushtanams are very rigid, some of them are not. Nitya karmas you have to do, but they also give exception. So if you cannot do madhyanigam, so try to do it in the morning itself. So if you come very late after 9 to 2 o'clock, then next morning, whatever you missed, you do that one. So there are certain kind of exception they give, prayaschittams and parigarams and everything for the lapse, because they know it is not possible 100% of the time we can follow. But if somebody leaves the three Sandhyavandanam, that means he has to put a new Upavidam, new Punar. Yagyobavidam, they have to put it again. So you cannot miss that much. That is the reason why the temple Vigraham, what they have, they do the Prana Pradishtai. So they have to do the Aradhanam every day. They cannot miss. If they miss, they have to do the Kumbhabhishekam again. Everything they have to start doing again. But for the home, we don't do Prana Pradishtai. So even if you go on a business trip for 1 week, when you come back, Perumal is so saulabhyam, so easily accessible. Oh, you come here, I understand, you can start doing puja from today. So the home Perumal is much easier for the temple that is more rigid. That's what I want to say. The acharam and anushtanam is somewhat flexible for home, not that much, very rigid for the temples. Even that the temple, that is why they are having Brahmotsavam. Brahmotsavam is the one every year they do. We try to do it so cleanly, without knowing ourselves, we would have made mistakes. So for that, abuddhipurvaka, abuddhi, we are not thinking deliberately without knowing. For that parigaram, they do Brahmotsavam. So Brahma comes and does the Utsavam for Perumal. That is why it's called Brahmotsavam. 10 days, they put Perumal in different bhagarams and everything, they do that one. So Krishna beautifully said, dharma is very important. And this dharma comes from achara. We found out two places you take it. In Sahasranamam, we saw yesterday, achara pradamam, parikalpide, that is the most important. Sarva agamanam, all agama sastrams are saying, this is very important. Krishna in Bhagavad Gita says, yada yada hi dharmasya klanir bhavadi bharada apyuttanam adharmasya tadhatmanam srujamyaham. Next he says, paritranaya sadhunam. Everybody knows that one. Yada yada hi dharmasya klani. When the dharma is reduced, they say dharma is like a cow which has got four legs in the Satya Yugam. And when it comes to the Treta Yugam, it's got three legs. When it comes to Dwapara Yugam, it's got two legs. When it comes to Kali Yugam, it's got a single leg. Dharma is standing like that one, limping. So that is what we are in. So Bhagavan makes the avataram, yada yada ki dharmasya klanir bhavadi bharada apyuttanam adharmasya. Adharma, when it is goes, the non-righteousness rises, that is where I come to this world and try to do. So Bhagavan will not let the dharma to go away. Bhagavan will not let the Vedas to go away. Vedas can go away and Bhagavan resurrect them. We saw the Matsyavadaram, Haigrivavadaram, that is what he does. So Bhagavan has to give you the rule book. Without that we cannot live. If you go to Moksham, if you go to Sri Vaikuntham, where Sada Pasyandi Surayaha, everybody see the Bhagavan. It's like a Matsya Drishti, Kurma Drishti. The mother fish, look at the baby fish. Looking itself is good enough for its stomach to fill. You don't have to feed it. Similarly, when you see the Bhagavan, you get everything jnanam. We don't need any Vedas, we don't need any Ramayana, we don't need any Bhagavatam in Moksham. because the Bhagavan is there. These are all relatively useless material when you compare to Bhagavan. So these are like a flashlight. With the flashlight, we want to find out where is the sun. The sun is Bhagavan, so bright and everything. So when I say useless in the sense, we should not make it like that. When you compare to the moksha, when Bhagavan is there, he is the most important. None of these things. But these things help you to understand the Bhagavan. Okay? So coming back here, that is what the acharam we saw yesterday. We finished that. Next one, we come to the kulam. Kulam means family, caste, race, clan, lineage. Any which way you can take that one. We go back to the first chapter of the Uddhava Gita. Uddhava Gita, what happened is, Krishna, when he decided to go back to Sri Vaikuntham, Brahma comes and says, Swami, you've been here for 125 years. That is where we know. So Brahma told that one, so is Brahma's counting. Brahma is in charge of all of them, so he lived only 125 years. Rama lived 11,000 years. He lived only 125 years. And at 125 years, Brahma said, the purpose you have come for the avadharam is done. So when you are going to go back, he was asking. So Krishna said, you read my mind. That is what my plan. And I have to do two things. One, I have to wipe out entire Yadukula. Second, I have to teach Uddhava Gita. So Krishna himself really wanted the last sermon, the last aspiration from Bhagavan. Look at that. One is completely wiping out. One is completely making everybody so good. These two he was saying. So nicely he was saying. For that, Krishna has to play a trick. Yadukulam is such a rich one and they are very skilled warriors, emperors, and they did everything good. So it's very difficult. It's like a Manhattan when you go in the Broadway, the all cars are tightly packed. So you have to find a bicycle to weave through that. So Krishna has to have a plan to weave through this one. Try to bring it down. Just like Star Wars, when you see that movie, finally they find a hole, you push through that, the whole thing is blast. So Krishna has to find a way like that one. So what he did, Krishna's one of the son is Jambavati, is one of the wife, Jambavan's daughter. So Jambavati's son is Sampan. So the Sampan is a very small, 10-year-old boy. They were all playing. At that time, there are 10 rishis, great rishis. And I used to say at that time, each rishi is like a nuclear power plant. All the 10 rishis put together there, they were all doing at one place some kind of a rishis open, like a US Open. Rishis Open were staying there. They were doing something about, contemplating about Bhagavan. At that time, Krishna made this mind into the Samban. So all these friends were playing. They made him like a girl, dressed him like a girl. Put him a big pestle on his stomach. And then they went to the rishi, says, this is a beautiful girl. This is a dark colored girl. Sampan is dark. This is a dark colored girl. And she is lajja. She is very shy and everything. And she is pregnant. What kind of a baby she would get? Whether male or a female gender. Rishis, they know everything. So, evam pralabdha munayaha tan uchaha kubidan rubaha jana ishyedi vo manda musalam kulanasanam. Musalam kulanasanam, that's very 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 important word. We repeat so many times. Nurupa, what the sugar brahmam is telling Parikshita Maharaja. Hey Parikshita Maharaja, listen to this one. Evam kupida, thus kupida, hangered munayaha, all these rishis, pralabdaha, they were tricked. Because of the trick, they got so mad, they angry. Tan uchaha, spoke to the small boys. What they said, jana ishyadi vo mandha. Hey fools, for you she will give birth, jana ishyadi. Musalam kulanasanam, he will give birth to a club, pestle. and that will completely wipe out your dynasty. So Krishna played. This is a very, very important one. Krishna says, look at that. How great this Vamsa, Krishna's own Vamsa, Yadukulam. That is wiped out for a simple trick. Why? Unknown trick. Why? By the small boys. They do it to the rishis. Never play with a sadhu. Never. That's what Krishna wants to say. Never try to doubt somebody. I don't know whether he is really a sadhu or whether he is doing pretending. He may not know anything. Never do that.
But there's another thing also. Lord Krishna can wipe out, generations of achievements in a second.
Correct. It happens. Because he wants to teach that one for two things. Even by the small boys, unknowingly they do, look at that. I don't know, I press the button. Sorry, that's a nuclear weapon. So, the sadhus, Bhagavan loves them. Never play with them. Never play with them. You may think like that. I give the thing, they carry the baby. Let's say, we carry the grandchildren. And when you look at them, the grandchildren is having all this cold and everything, nose is dripping. Dripping alert. So, he is wearing Armani suit. It goes and wipes that. That is what Bhagavan. You may think that sadhu is coming out with all these dripping waters. But Bhagavan takes the Armani suit and wipes them. Who are you to guess them? Who are you to judge them? Never, never play with this sadhu. That is what we told at that time. Somebody who is good, never suspect somebody's bhakti. Never suspect, never say bad words about it. They are just making that. Never say that. Bhagavan doesn't like that. All we can do, very, very simple. We do our path. Why do worry about why we have to bad mouth anything? So Krishna has to play a trick like that. That is fair. And in that one, musalam kulanasanam. That kulam is very important. That is what I am coming into. So if one person does something wrong like that one, the whole kulam is gone. So that is the reason. If one person does a good thing, the whole thing will flourish. So the kulam is very, very important. After the acharam, you look at it. What kind of a family I come from? Who are my elders and everything? What rishis I was following? And how I should behave? That is very important. That is what we are saying. In Kurathalvam, Ramanuja's Sishya, right hand, is 10 years older than Ramanuja. But he is a Sishya. He is called Mukkurumba Arutthanam Kurathalvan. Three kind of mischiefs we always have. Three kind of ego. Dhanamadam, Vidyamadam, Kulamadam. Dhanamadam means ego. I am the rich person. Vidyamadam. I am the only one knows what these people know. They don't know anything. I know everything. Kulamadam. Do you know what family I come from? What heritage I have? Never say that. He never had any of them. In fact, all the three, he had the highest class. He gave up. And he says, I'm the lowest one. So we had to get rid of kula matham. Never think that you are so great. I'm a Brahmin clan. I'm coming from this rishi. I'm coming from this family. This is my last name. Never say that. But you have to behave for that. But you cannot boast that one. That is what it's saying here. Alvar said beautifully, Kulam tarum selvam tandidum narayana ennum namam. If you say that namam, the nama narayana, it will give you the right kulam. It will give you the wealth. Whatever the pavas you said, it removed that one. Everything. Petratayanam ayana seyyum. More than the mother who gave birth to you, this narayana word will do more good for you. That is what he says. So, Narayana, if you look at that one, she gave birth only once. Bhagavan gave birth so many times to you, millions of janma. So, this is only body kind of a mother. He is a soul mother for us. So, that is why Bhagavan is more important. He will give you good kulam. That is also, he says. The first one, he says, kulam tarum. Put you in a nice kulam. Then, செல்வம் தென் தி வெல்த் இட் கிவ்ஸ். வை இஃப் யூ ஆர் இன் அ குட் குலம், இஃப் யூ ஆர் இன் அ குட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் எ டைனஸ்டி, வென் தி வெல்த் கம்ஸ் யூ ஸ்பெண்ட் இட் இன் தி ரைட் வே, நாட் தி உல்டா. சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி ஆழ்வார் சேஸ் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம். நாட் ஓன்லி தீஸ் பீப்புள், குலசேகர் ஆழ்வார் ஒரு முகுந்தமாலா இன் தமிழ் ஹீரோ பெரிய திருமொழி, தேர் இ டெல்லிங் அபவுட் ராமா. செங்கதிரோன் குலத்திற்கோர் விளக்காய் தோன்றி, செங்கதிரோன் ஹார்ட் பேர்னிங் சன், தட் சன்ஸ் டைனஸ்டி. ராமா இஸ் லைக் எ ஹியூஜ் தீபம், எவ்ரிபடி கேன் சி அண்ட் பெனிஃபிட் அவுட் ஆஃப் தட். ஸோ சூரிய வம்சம், ராமா இஸ் பார்ன் ஃப்ரம் சூரிய வம்சம், தே கால் ரகு வம்சம், தே கால் இஷ்வாகு வம்சம், ஆல் தோஸ் திங்ஸ் ஆர் தி சேம், சேம் பீப்புள் இன் தி டைனஸ்டி. ஸோ ஃப்ரம் தி சூரிய வம்சம், கிருஷ்ணா இஸ் வந்து சந்திர வம்சம், ஸோ ராமா இஸ் வந்து சூரிய வம்சம். ஸோ செங்கதிரோன் குலத்துக்கோர் விளக்கு, ஈவன் பகவான் யூஆர் கிரேட். வென் யூ ஆஸ்க் ராமா, யூ ஆல்வேஸ் சுஷோஸ், யூ நோ ஹவு மை டைனஸ்டி ஆர். தட் இஸ் வாட் வென் விஸ்வாமித்ரா கம் யூ ஆர் சேயிங், அஸ் சூன் அஸ் விஸ்வாமித்ரா கம் திஸ் தசரதன் டஸ் நாட் நோ, தசரதன் இஸ் நாட் அ ஸ்மார்ட் பர்சன். ஈ கோஸ் டு ஹிம், ஓ ரிஷி யூ கம் ஓவர் ஹியர், I'm ready to give anything you ask, I will give you. Don't open your mouth, give an empty check first. Then he says, I want your 2 cents. He goes, oh, heart attack. These 2 kids are 12 years old, balakas. They don't even know. They need a teddy bear to sleep with. And you are asking to go and fight with all the rakshasas. Then Vishwamitra got so mad. You know what dynasty you come from? Look at all of them. சூரியன், ரகுவம்சம், இஷ்வாகு, திலீபன், ஹரிச்சந்திரன், நளன், மாந்தாதா, அம்பரிஷன், ஆல் தோஸ். இஃப் யூ லுக் அட் ராமாஸ் டைனஸ்டி, கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ் அபவுட் யது, யது இஸ் ஒன்லி ஒன், யது இஸ் ஒன்லி ஒன், யது இஸ் எ கிரேட் கிங். வி சா தட் ஒன், ஹி வாஸ் ஹெல்பிங் ஹிஸ் பேரண்ட் டு ஸ்விட்ச் தி ஓல்ட் ஏஜ் அண்ட் எவ்ரி திங் ஹி டிட், பட் Rama's dynasty is amazing. Amazing warriors, each one of them. So, that dynasty you have come, in any of them, Tulasidas Ramayanam, beautiful, I don't remember, beautiful slogan it comes. Vase Dasharatha, in your dynasty, is there anyone who went back on that word? A single word he never went back. And you call, you come from that dynasty, that is what asking Vishwamitra.
So, Rukul Sadam, you remember that.
ரகுகுல சதா பிரதீட்சை, பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஸ்லோகம், வண்டர்ஃபுல் ஸ்லோகம். ஐ டோன்ட் ரிமெம்பர் தட் ஒன், பட் வென் யூ ஹியர் அமேசிங் இஸ் எனி ஒன் வென்ட் பேக் ஆன் அ சிங்கிள் வேர்ட் அண்ட் யூ கால் யூ ஆர் இன் தட் டைனஸ்டி, தட் இஸ் வாட் தே ஆர் சேயிங். ஸோ வென் யூ லுக் பேக், ஹவு மை ஃபாதர், ஹவு கிராண்ட் ஃபாதர் தேர், யூ ஷுட் கீப் தட் ஒன் அப். வாட் மை ஃபாதர் லேர்ன், the religion I know only 10% of it, but my father is only 10% of the grandfather. So we are getting so minuscule amount, at least it's something we do, but it is not, some things are changing. Remember this last weekend I went to the Toronto house, there I saw the father and the small son is in the 5th grade. The kid takes shower every time before he does the sandhya vandana. I felt so embarrassed. And we do with the pant and shirt and a suit and everything, not even something on our head. This is a small kid. So we cannot say the other generations are getting bad. Nowadays there are a lot of them. It's Bhagavan's blessings. One of the gentlemen was remarked, oh boy, beautiful, he does all this kankariyam to Pirumal and everything. Sir, don't look at that one. His father doesn't even step into the temple. The son is doing like that. It's Bhagavan's blessing. So we cannot say that one. But the knowledge level somewhere or other, it is slowly reduced. We don't have that much time to learn all of them. My father used to recite almost all the Ramayana slokas. Any slokas he has, he remembers all of them. And Ragasetra Saram, he remembers that one. So when he compared to that one, even Tirukudandi Antavan used to say, my acharyas, when they teach ரகசியத்ரய சாரம், ரகசியத்ரய சாரம், தர் ஆர் 3 மந்த்ராஸ் ஆர் தேர், அஷ்டாட்சரம், துவயம், சரம ஸ்லோகம், the meanings of that one, Ragasya Traya Saram. Meanings of that one. So huge book Swami Desikan has written, maybe about 1500 pages are there. So in that book, he says, I have to open up and read for when I teach. But my acharya and everything, after they come from taking bath, they will wear all this veshti and everything, and put it all the kachas and everything, and put the thiruman everywhere. At that time, they will be reciting the whole 2000 book. They will be reciting to the disciple and teaching. That is the way they are. So those, as the generation comes, we don't learn that much. So the kulam tarum selvam tandidum, Alvar says, Bhagavan, if you pray to Narayana, he gives a good clan. Even Rama, you come from that clan and everything. So kulam is very, very important. What Rama did, when the Pattabhishegam happens, Rama Pattabhishegam, he has killed the Ravana, Kumbhakarna, all the bad people, come on the Pushpaka Vimanam, and Bharata was very happy, he was ruling with the Padukas, and he put Rama into that one, Vaidehi Sagidam Sam, Suratru Madale Haime Mahamandabe. So that sloka, we say that one, where he is sitting down in Ratna Mandapam, and all of them are surrounding him, and each one comes close, and Rama wants to give great gift. So Vibhishana comes. He looks at Vibhishana. Vibhishano Abhi. This Vibhishana, even what he is, Abhi. Abhi word is very important. Dharmatma. You have to understand Dharmatma. His brother is a Rakshaseswaran. But Vibhishana is a Dharmatma. You have to understand, even within the same kulam, same caste, what I told yesterday, gunas are different. You have to classify in two levels. Where you are born, what gunas you inherited. These two. What gunas you inherit, you can always change. You can be a good person tomorrow. But you cannot get blonde hair tomorrow, unless you die. We are born into certain things. That is, Bhagavan has made that. I gave example of Alvar yesterday. So Bhagavan makes that. So Vibhishano Abhi Dharmatma. Beautiful. Hey, don't look at the body. It's a super soul, Vibhishana. Saha Labdhva Kuladanam. He gave the Kuladanam. Raja Lankanam. So for the king of the Lanka, Vibhishana, Rama gave the Kuladanam. What is the Kula Dhanam? Valmiki did not write it specifically. So we have to put conjecture and find out. So when Rama was given, so we are diverting a little into Ramayana. So when Rama was announced, his father and everybody told Rama, tomorrow we are going to do the Pattabhishegam for you. You are the Yuvaraj. Crowning. So we are going to do the crowning for you. So, you are not anymore a prince, you are going to be the king, you are going to be the emperor, they said that one. So, Rama was very happy. So, he come, Sagapatnya Vishalaksha Narayana Ubhagamadu, wonderful slogan, part of the slogan. In Ramayana, very, very important. He says, Sagapatnya Vishalaksha, Rama went to Sita and said, do you know, my father said, tomorrow is a crowning ceremony for me. Our eyes were brightened so much. She says, let's go and pray. Sagapatnya Vishalakshya Narayana Ubhagamad. Let's go and do the Aradhanam for our Perumal. The Kuladhanam. Kuladhanam, what they are having is Ranganada. Lord Ranganada in that Vimanam, Ungaram, that is Pranavagara Vimanam, Rama had that one. What happened is, it is coming from Bhagavan in Moksham, in Vaikuntham. Brahma cannot go, because when you think of, we are all in this prakriti below that moksha. If you go to moksha, it's a one way. When you go to moksha, it's a one way. When you go there is no karma. You can come back, but there is no karma attached to you. You always come with the return ticket. You can walk by. Bhagavan can send you, but when you go there, all karmas are gone. But Brahma has got karma here. That is why he is here. Brahma cannot go. So Brahma is asking the Bhagavan, I cannot pray. I don't have anything about you. I'm doing manasigam. Is there anything you can give me? So Perumal makes himself as a Ranganada from moksha. he gives. This is only Perumal that is descended from there. So he gave it to Brahma. Brahma is doing so many different yugas, this Aradhana for that Ranganatha. And then the son is asking, S-O-N, S-U-N, both. His son is asking that one. He's asking that one, how can I pray? So he gave it to them. That is how the Surya Vamsa got. And then Raghu, Dilipan, Harishchandran, everybody was doing the Aradhana. And Rama, the first thing what you do, when you get anything really great, oh, thanks. Bhagavan, thanks. Prayer is nothing but saying thanks to Bhagavan. That is what Rama shows. Once you said, you're going to be the king, you're going to be crowned. Oh, thanks Bhagavan, he wants to go. Rama himself is the Bhagavan. He shows to us how you have to say, Sagapatnya, along with the wife, not alone. Everybody has to be in the same way, mindset. Sagapatnya Visalakshya Narayana Upakamati. There, they did not say Kuladanam and they did not say Ranganara. They said Narayana, you take that one. And where it came from, moksham, here there's a Kuladhanam, you put a conjecture, this is Pranavakara Vimanam with Ranganatha. So, what can I give you? The highest thing I can give you, Vibhishana, Dharmatma, look at that word. Perumal looks at what, Jnani to Atmaime Me Madham. Krishna says, everybody thinks Bhagavan is inside and we are all controlled by him. Bhagavan is the Paramatma. No. Bhagavan says, Jnani is more. I am inside them. That is me madham. Krishna says, how beautifully. Your philosophy may be different. My philosophy, Krishna says, Jnanis are important. So when he says, Dharmatma, when he saw that one, beautiful. There is another reason also Rama, why he gave that. Because Rama made a mistake. Very rarely we see Rama makes mistake. Where he makes a mistake? He cries. He says he made a mistake and he cries in Ramayana at the end. He says, let me give you a story. He says about two stories. One of the stories is Kapodagam, the dove. The dove. There was one forest. In the forest, there's a hunter comes in. And when the hunter comes in, it tries to hit one of the dove and he got that one and its wing was broken. He put them in the cage. He got that one and he was going. And when he went all the different ways, it was lightning and thunder, rain. It was all big cyclone air and everything. He does not know. He was hungry. He does not know where he is. So finally, he comes with that cage to the same tree where both of them had the nest. The husband was looking for the, where is my wife? He could not find it. And when this hunter comes and falls there with the cage, the female bird inside the cage tells to the male, look at this person. He has taken Sharanagari to our home. We have to help him. He feels very cold. So why don't you go and get all these wood pieces and everything, make the fire, let him be warm. So this one, the male also lost one side of the wing. With one wing, it keeps on going, bring all these wood pieces and put them into the fire, and it's a huge fire was there, so the hunter felt a little warm. And then the female inside the cage says, look at this guy, he looks very hungry. He's a guest, he's an aditi in our home, and he's taken refuge on that. Why don't you jump into that fire? Let him eat you. That female said. Rama says this one in Ramayana and he cries. Why he cries? He says, when Vibhishana comes on the sky with the four Rakshasas and he says, Sarvaloga Saranyaya Raghavaya Mahatmane. What a beautiful word he says. Sarvaloga Saranyaya, for all the people anywhere, Rama, you are the only refuge. Raghavaya Mahatmane, nobody is like you, Rama. He said like that one, he's coming. What did I do? We have hold on to him. We have a meeting here. In a meeting where there's a Sugriva groups over there and everybody, the Anjaneya there, we are discussing, is this guy is the right guy? Whether we should give refuge for him? Whether he will do any damage to that? When somebody takes a refuge, it doesn't matter. Even they hurt you, you have to give. I never knew that one. Rama says, look at this dove. Dove, this hunter came to that home, he didn't ask for a refuge. He never openly said in his mouth. By the action falling into that one, this bird, this dove, understood that. It asked the male dove, the most important spouse, to give up the life. What kind of a stupid person I am. How this Vibhishana's heart would be beating. Remember in those days, when we write exams, public exams, your number will come on the paper. So you open up the paper and keep on looking through. Look how your heartbeat will be there until you know. Similar to that one, how his heartbeat will be there. What I should have done when Vibhishana said that, I should have gone and greeted and welcomed him to bring here. Vibhishana, don't worry. I will give anybody who takes refuge. I did not do that. He felt so sorry. Rama, from his own mouth, I made a mistake. Look at that. What mistake? Said delay. That delay, how much his heart would be suffered. So Rama wanted to do parigaram for that. So that's why my Perumal, the highest one, he will always be with you. That is why he gave the Kuladhanam to him. Not even to Anjaneya. Not even to Anjaneya. Anjaneya, he gave the garland to him. This pearl and everything, necklace from Sita, what he gave that one. Other than that, for Vibhishana, the highest one he gave, because he missed treating him when he came as a refuge. So Rama himself says, I made that one. He tells the story and he cries before he goes to back. So that is why when we take refuge on the Bhagavan, when he says like that, definitely we will do. We say, who is an Acharyan? Acharyan is the one, if somebody comes to you as a disciple, he is cutting your left hand with a knife. With the right hand, he is putting Akshade for him. Dirga Ishman, even though he is cutting your hand. If an ordinary Acharya is like that, Paramacharya, Krishna, how he would be, Rama, how he would be, Narayana, how he would be, that is why he says, the Kulam is very important. That kind of a thing he came. Rama will not make any mistake. From his viewpoint, delaying was a mistake. There's no mistake. From his viewpoint, I should have done more. So that is why when you go to Perumal and you say, I'm taking the refuge, all you have to say only once. Don't do it second time, Perumal says. Bhagavan says, don't do it second time. One time you did, I give the Vaikuntham whole thing to you. If you do second time, I don't have anything else to give you. I am become pauper. Everything is yours. That is how Bhagavan treats. So the Kulam is very, very important. That kind of a thing becomes. So we have to look at ourselves. What kind of a Kulam? How we uphold our lineage. That is what it is. The way how we say the Kulam, when we prostrate, I had to emphasize this one, mainly because many people may not know, or at least woman does not know. Whenever we prostrate to the elderly people, we do something, introduction of ourselves. It's called Abhivadaye. I am surrendering on your feet, I am telling this one. Abhivadaye. What you basically do over here, you tell what is your Gotra, what is your Veda Sutra, and what Shaka it is, what is Pravara, what kind of a Rishi Gotras you are coming from. Gotram, what Rishis are there. So, when I introduce myself, not shaken in this country, in India when you do, put your, because the reason why you put your thing, you don't want to hear that, because you will get ego. Even though your mind knows, just to give that bhavam, I'm telling all of them, there's no ego. Bhagavan put me into that one. I never What did I do? I went to Bhagavan, I asked, okay, I want to be born here. We never did any of them. He blesses us on that. So when I do that one, Abhivadaye, Angirasa, Ambarisha, Yavanashva. These are the three rishis. Either three rishis or five rishis, people will tell. In my one, only three rishis. Abhivadaye, Angirasa, Ambarisha, Yavanashva. Traya Rishayaha, three rishis. Harida Gotraha, my gotram is Harida Gotram. Sivatsa Gotram, Sadamashana Gotram, so many different gotra. So, Harida Gotra, Abhastamba Sutraha. The Sutram, Bodhayana Sutram is there, Abhastamba Sutram is there. So, my one is Abhastamba Sutra. Abhastamba explained the Veda, how the rituals has to be performed. I'll give you the Abhastamba story in a different place. Abhastamba Sutra. Yajur Shakatyagi. The Shaka what I'm using is Yajur Vedam. Samavedam, Rig Vedam. So, Yajur Sagai. Rajagopala Nama Sarmana. Aham Asvipo. I am praying to you. Abhibade Angirasa Ambarisha Yavanasva Trayarishayaga Pravaran Vidaha Arida Gotraha Abhastamba Sutraha Yajusagatyagi Rajagopala Nama Sarmana Agam Asvibo. That is how you say. So when you say this one, here you say what is your Gotra, Arida Gotra, what is the Sutra, Abhastamba Sutra, what Shaka, Yajusaga, what is the Pravaram, the three rishis, Angirasa, Ambarisha, Yavanasva. I come from this. So that is the clan you are coming from. You don't have to introduce your father or grandfather. That is the clan. That is good enough. Because they upheld that one. So just like Krishna says, my forefathers, Yadu Maharaja did like this. See that? Krishna says, first, they are Yadukula. Then only he speaks. Okay? So similarly, we have to uphold our kulam. So these three rishis find our kulam. Gotras. This is very important. Why we have to know the Gotras? We are going to spend some time on that one. When you look, main reason Gotra is find, we come from that kind, if there's a river, it is a pure river going on that. No adulteration. So when you come on the Gotra, main reason where it is used, when you get married. When you get married, you don't get married in the same Gotra. That means Sagotra. That means they are like your brothers and sisters. We never get married. If they do, it is incest. So that is the reason we don't do that. And besides, scientifically and medically, they find there are so many problems, mutations and all these things, they will magnify all of them. So when you get married, these gotras are important. In fact, the gotra pravanam, if you go for the Kalyana Utsavam, Tirupati Balaji Perumal, they do Kalyana Utsavam. There they read the Pravaram. The Pravaram is their genealogy. So this is the Bhagavan for all this Gotra he was coming and everything. This is the Batmavadi Tayar, Agasa Raja Putri and everything. They will be reading all of them. So they are getting married like that. So when you have the boy and the girl, the groom and the bride, when you have that, they should not be in the same Gotra. People say this is some kind of an artificial one. So let me adopt this kid into a different Gotra. Adoption will not change. So now the Gotra has changed, so we can get married. You're trying to find a bypass. That is not allowed. There are people do for some reasons. The another one, when you are in the Gotra, it goes for 7 generations. So when people die, Sapinti Karanam, they do that one. When they put the rice balls, 3 generations when you do, all your father's cousin, your grandfather's cousin, your great-grandfather's cousin, everybody is there in the same Gotra lineage. Everybody will have that pollution, titu for 10 days, pollution. All those things will be there. Everybody has to follow. They are all Saga Gotra. You cannot get married into that one. In South India, let me first give that one and then we go to the North India. In South India, there are something called parallel cousins and cross cousins. Parallel cousins are the one, both of them are brothers. Brothers' kids are parallel cousins. Sisters' kids are parallel cousins. They cannot get married. If there's a brother and a sister there, that is called cross cousin. So the brother's son and sister's daughter, they can get married. So the cross cousins get married. You cannot do in this country. At least about 38 states or so, they say it is illegal. That's why I said in South. In South, cross cousins can get married. When the siblings are different gender, their generations get married because the girl get married to somebody, so the gotram is different. That's what they, that is the underpinning. But that is also not, from medical reasons, that's also not correct, because the chances of something bad happens is more. And then, if you go to the, and the thing is, we never worry about, let's assume, the boy, father's gotram he takes, the mother maiden name, wherever she comes from, let's say the father's gotram is Vishwamitra gotram, so there, the mother's maiden name, mother says coming from, let's say Harida gotram. So in South, when the kids are getting married, the mother's maiden gotram they can get married, but in North you cannot. Both father's side and mother's side is Saga gotram. They are more restrictive on this one. So compared to the South, North, they follow much more in this kulam, especially in the marriages and everything. They follow that both of the gotras, you cannot get married. That is where your product you have come from. So that is how they maintain the cleanliness of the gotram. Let's assume you can get married. So many cross things could have happened. Mother said you could have get married. Then so many things would have happened. Now it is purely maintained, both of them. See that one? How nicely they have done. So that is why they do mainly health reasons, blood cannot be polluted and everything. All these things, that kulam is very important. And that is determined by this gotra. Okay. And in kulam, not only this gotra, we'll start today, we might finish in the next class, the whole first chapter of Bhagavad Gita. We'll switch that one to Bhagavad Gita, where Arjuna comes so pumped. I want to kill all these people. My name is Vijayan. I want to win victory. He comes there, but when he saw all the people, he got the war jitters. He said, trembling. So Krishna said, why are you trembling? Why don't you go and hit them? He says, no, I cannot do that one. Kula kshaya kridam dosham. That is the word he is using. He's going to tell about 10 slokas over there in the first chapter. By killing, by doing all your own kulam, what are the problems? Whom is he telling? He's telling to Krishna, he did his own kulanasana. Krishna didn't do that yet. That is where the difference between Bhagavan and human being. You will never be a Bhagavan. He can do any of them. His reasons we cannot understand. What we know is very little. So when you compare this Bhagavad Gita beginning and Uddhava Gita at the end, when you make that one, Krishna says, kulanasanam, because he has to protect himself, he has to defend himself. Go ahead and do. That is what your job. I have to do that one later, he is going to tell. He is doing it as a Bhagavan, but you are doing it as a Kshatriyan. Okay, that is how you have to. Here Krishna has to do, because none of them is his enemies. All of them are his own clan. But still, I have a bigger duty. I will not let any empire to get big. We have seen so many of them. We saw the Mughalai Empire and British Empire, everything has got Greek and Romans and everything. None of them bet and just go back. That is what Krishna wanted to do. I don't want to get it so big, we have to reduce that one. So, kula, kshaya, kridam, dosham. So, probably next class, we'll talk a little more on Bhagavad Gita, the first chapter, where there's an argument between Krishna and the Arjuna, that will be able to do that one. That tells you why kulam is very important. Okay. Kavitharkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunasarine Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Srimade Nehavanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha.